Much can be learned by comparing the prophet Samuel the Lamanite from the Book of Mormon with the prophet Samuel of the Old Testament. Both had similar prophetic calls, both foretold a coming Messiah, both wielded God's sword of justice, and both subverted societal expectations. As a young boy, the biblical Samuel trained under a temple priest named Eli. Even though Eli was supposed to be the spiritual guide for Israel, it was the boy Samuel upon whom the Lord repeatedly called and to whom the Lord revealed his will. Samuel the Lamanite was an outsider to the Nephites, and the Lamanites in particular were not people to whom the Nephites looked for religious guidance. Just as the biblical Samuel unexpectedly heard and hearkened to the voice of the Lord in his youth, Samuel the Lamanite heard and preached the word of the Lord to the Nephites, against all expectations of the established covenant community. From this we learn that whom the Lord calls, he clearly qualifies. The Nephites would hardly have expected a Lamanite to deliver to them such an important prophetic speech. Yet the Lamanites, as a people, were unexpectedly more righteous at that time than the Nephites. Readers can appreciate the importance of not assuming righteousness or virtue based on someone's group affiliation or based on one's preconceived notions. Samuel's teachings were so important, and apparently overlooked in part by the Nephite record keepers, that Jesus Christ himself commanded that one of Samuel's prophecies be restored to the Nephite records. In these and other ways, the two stories of Samuel the Lamanite and of Samuel the Ephraimite strikingly show how the Lord seeth not as man seeth, for man looketh on the outward appearance, but the Lord looketh on the heart. And now you know why.